Greetings in the precious name of Jesus. Welcome to the service of CRC. We thank you for joining us this morning, and our prayer is that you will sit back and relax in the comfort of your home and wherever you are at this moment. COVID-19 has given the world a wake-up call, and this has woken up a lot of our people. It has already claimed many lives, and many thousands are still to get well when this virus is still spreading throughout the world. This morning, our prayer and our prayer should be for those that are there, the doctors, the scientists, those people that are trying to get the medication, the physicians, the nurses, the ambulance drivers, the paramedics, all those people that are risking their lives at such a state that where they could contact that disease, but yet they've taken up the courage to be there to do the work that they have called to do. And our prayer is that the Lord will protect them. This is what it is. We are in our comfort of our home, lockdown. We need to be locked up praying for these people, that God will touch them and God will protect them and God will heal them and God will protect those that are there for the service of all those people. And this morning, we just bring a scripture to you, a reminder of Psalm 91. Psalm 91 says that in verse 4, He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. And look what the Lord says. He will cover you with His feathers. So if you would dwell in His shelter, He will definitely cover you, and He will cover you and protect you under His wings, and you would be there without any interference, and nothing will come near you. So let us at this time be protected by the precious blood of Jesus and by His feathers, and so we can dwell in His presence all the time. This is what Psalmist David warned us. Psalmist David's prayer was, let it be our prayer that we want to be in the shelter of our King Jesus. Bless you all, and be blessed this morning as you would listen to the message and as you would sing and praise God at this time. And be blessed. Protect yourself. Remember, the warning is that we need to keep ourselves sanitized, wash our hands, and be careful and be aware of things around. Bless you. God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.
rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great
Hello everyone, we really are grateful to God for a platform like this where we'll be able to anchor each other's souls in the Word of God and strengthen one another's faith. I'm going to be guiding us and leading us in a time of prayer briefly, and to start us off, I want to read a verse from the Word of God, Job chapter 42, verse number 2. Let me read it quickly. It says, I know that you can do everything, and that no purpose of yours can be withheld from you. Let's bow to pray. Our Heavenly Father, we want to honor you today. We want to worship and adore you, our God. We are so grateful that we can be reminded, O God, in this fashion, my Father, of your sovereignty, that you alone are in charge, that you alone are in control. You do as you please in the world, O God. It is you, our Father, who is in control of everything, not the devil, not nature, not sinful people, O God. You are in charge. And to this sovereign Lord, we want to present our lives, we present the lives of our families, O God, that you protect us, our God, that you draw us even more than before, closer to one another and closer to your God. Father, this world is changing time and time again, our Father. And when we realize that, O God, we are so happy to know that you are unchanging. Your plans, your purposes, O God, remain unshakable. And, O Father God, one of your plans, O God, is that you have designed, O God, in your wisdom, to plant the church, O God, in these times, O God. And we know that for that reason it is still relevant, O God. And I pray, therefore, Father, that you raise your church, that you wake your church up, O God, that you cause your people to pray. Father, we thank you as well, Spirit of the living God, for the wisdom you've given to our leaders in our nation, my Heavenly Father, that, oh God, they'll be able to guide us down, to guide us during this lockdown, oh God. I thank you, Father, for those people that are educating themselves accordingly during this coronavirus outbreak, oh God, and taking right precautions, my Father, and so that we can limit the spread of this virus, oh God. And Lord, yet I pray for those that needs to be guided by you, those that are still a bit stubborn, oh God, those that are still dismissive of the reality of the condition that the world is in, oh God. I pray, Father, especially now, my Father, for those that are frontliners, those that are food soldiers, oh God, those that are risk takers, oh God, our doctors, our nurses, those that are all part of the medical fraternity, that, my Father, that you protect them, that you strengthen them, that you give them wisdom, oh God, and intelligence to discover even the virus, oh God. Lord, we know that our ultimate trust is not just in finding and really accessing the virus or the vaccine, oh God, but our ultimate trust, oh God, is in you, oh God. When the whole world is shaking and fearful, oh God, we pray that, oh God, anchor us. Remind us, Father, that our hope is in you, God. That we don't have to fear that which can only kill the body, but we should also fear you, O God, who is able to kill the body and take it into hell, O God. We pray for the penetration of your gospel during this time and your peace and hope in the world, O God, to be restored among all the people, O God, in Jesus' name during this time. We thank you and we praise you. Friends, we want to thank God. Enjoy the remaining time of our service. God bless you.
Hello everybody, I trust that you are well and your families are all well and you're praying very hard for this season to pass very quickly. And I'm so happy that during this time we can share God's word with you on this platform. Palm Sunday. The time, or the day rather, when Jesus entered Jerusalem riding on a donkey. Just as the prophet Zechariah prophesied, he would. People gathered all around, throwing their cloaks in front of him, throwing palm branches down and shouting out, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" Because our King Jesus had come to earth to save all of mankind from their sins. He died, he paid the price for our sins, and he reconciled us to God. He rose again on Easter Sunday, he ascended on Ascension Day, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, praying for you and me. Jesus sustains us every single day through the power of his Holy Spirit. And this is what I want us to talk about today. So won't you turn with me to the book of Hebrews chapter 1, and we'll read it. We'll read the first four verses. Hebrews chapter 1. In the past, God spoke to our ancestors through prophets at many times and in various ways. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, and through whom he also made the universe. The Son is the radiance of God's glory and the exact representation of his being, sustaining all things by his powerful word. And after he had provided purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty in heaven. So he became as much superior to the angels as the name he inherited is superior to theirs. Amen. Let us pray. O God, would you, through your Holy Spirit, open up our hearts and minds today to consider this text before us, O God. Help us to find truth that we can hold on to firmly during such times as these. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. In this portion of scripture, we find this, the author accrediting a few attributes to Jesus. He's the Son of God. He's the co-creator. He's the heir of all things, the rightful owner to everything. He's the redeemer. He's the king. And he's the sustainer. Yes, Jesus is our sustainer. During these difficult times that we face, remember that Jesus is our sustainer. And today, we want to look at a few of the sustaining works that Jesus does so that we can draw strength and put our faith and trust in him. So what is the definition of a sustainer, or what does it mean to sustain? It really means to uphold, to care for, to nurture, to make sure that every need is provided for. Just like a father who would go to work, who would work very hard to bring income home so that his family could buy food to eat, to live. When the child gets sick or someone in his household gets sick, he takes them to the doctor to get treatment, or to the chemist to get medication, or to the hospital if need be. This is the work of a sustainer. And Jesus is our sustainer, providing for all our needs. No matter what your need is, Jesus can provide for it. One of the best things, in fact, the most important thing Jesus has done for us was to come to earth to save sinners like you and I. And why did Jesus do it? Well, Jesus knew that a holy creator, our holy creator, cannot have a relationship with sinful man. We inherited our sin from Adam, and it has been passed down to every generation up until this day. And so we cannot have a relationship with a holy God being sinful. Because we do not have a relationship with God, we stand in opposition to God. We are not on his side. Those who are not on his side are those who rebel against God, like the devil and all of his demons, and all those who do not accept God's way of salvation. Those are the ones that will see God's judgment. His wrath will be poured out on them. They will be cast into an eternal lake of fire. But that's not where it ends. Jesus, thank God for sending Jesus down to this earth, the sinless Lamb of God, who was sacrificed on a cross. His blood poured out for you and me. And that sacrifice was accepted by God to make atonement for all of our sins, for all times. Now you and I can have our sins forgiven. We can be purified. We can be reconciled to God through believing in Jesus, who has brought God's salvation to us. All we gotta do is believe that Jesus Christ died for our sins, was raised to life on the third day, and becomes Lord of our lives, reconciling us to the Father and living in us through His Holy Spirit. It is only through faith in Jesus that you and I can escape our eternal punishment. It is only through faith in Jesus that you and I can be reconciled to God and enjoy union with Him as He intended at the beginning of creation. The next work that Jesus does for us to sustain us, He heals us. He has the power to heal all of our sicknesses. I'm reminded of the woman with the issue of blood. She had been suffering for 12 years with this issue, that she was continually bleeding, non-stop. And she went to many doctors and many physicians to try and get a remedy for the situation, but nothing helped. She spent all her money, and eventually she was declared unclean as an outcast of society, until she heard that Jesus, Son of God, will be walking through her streets that day. She knew, and she believed with all her heart, that if she just touched Jesus, she will be healed. And that's what she did. She got into the marketplace where the crowd was, wormed her way through until she got to Jesus, went right down and touched the hem of His garment. And immediately she was healed. Jesus stopped because He knew power had gone out of him. And when He inquired, He found that this was the woman that had been battling the sickness for 12 years. He looked at her and He said, "Woman, your faith has made you whole. Go in peace." Our faith in Jesus will allow Him to sustain us, sustain our health. I don't know what's your condition of health right now, but whatever it is, Jesus has the power to heal you. You just gotta put your faith and trust in Him. Another way that Jesus sustains us is He delivers us out of all trouble. Think of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. King Nebuchadnezzar wanted them to bow down to the image that he had made for all of Babylon to worship. And they told him very boldly, in a respectable way, "King, we want you to know that we will not bow down to this image. Even if we be thrown into the fire, our God is able to save us, and He will save us from that and from your hand. And even if He doesn't save us, we want you to know that we will not bow down." The king got angry. He ordered that that furnace be heated up 7 times more. Even the soldiers that threw these 3 men into the furnace were burnt up themselves and died. That's how hot the fire was. And then the king looks into the furnace and he sees that he threw in 3 men, but there's 4 of them. And the 4th one looks like the Son of God. And he calls out for them to come out. And as they come out, none of them, nor their clothes or their turbans or anything, was burnt. Not even smoke could be smelt on them. And God was praised that day. King Nebuchadnezzar even made a ruling that if anyone says anything bad about the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, their bodies will be cut to pieces and their homes be turned into a pile of rubble. I don't know what your furnace is. I don't know what your times of troubles are. But I'm here to tell you that in those times of trouble, Jesus will be with you. He will protect you so that those times of trouble you are surrounded by will not consume you. You will come out of it without a smell of smoke on your clothing. So today, I want to encourage you. Let us receive this sustenance that only Jesus can provide for us. And how do we receive it? We receive it through faith in Him alone. We receive it by believing that He is able to do what we ask Him to do. Mark 11, 24 says, "Whatever you ask in prayer, believe that you have received it and it will be yours." So whatever your need is, pray. Pray to Jesus, who is your King, who is your Creator, who is your Redeemer, who is the one that owns us. He also sustains us. He will provide for you. I don't know what your need is. I don't know what trouble you face, whether it be trouble in your marriage, trouble in your family. Maybe you need a job and need income to put food on the table. Jesus knows your every trouble. Maybe you're suffering from hurt. I'm asking you, give all your troubles to Jesus. Give your sicknesses to Jesus. Give your worries to Jesus. Give every struggle you face to Jesus. He will sustain you. He will keep you. He says in His word, in Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10, He says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." Don't be fearful today. Jesus, your sustainer, is here. He has all the power to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can imagine and think of. And He's willing to do it today if you put your faith and trust in Him. You will never be put to shame. Let us pray. Father, we thank You for Your word that teaches us that Jesus, You will sustain us. You will keep us safe during these times, O God. You will help us. You will send the answers, O God, that we so desperately seek. I ask for those who have not placed their trust in You, O God. For those who don't know, Lord Jesus, that You came to earth to save us from the punishment of our sins, from God's wrath and God's judgment, O God. I pray that as they would hear this, they would consider this message today, that Jesus can save your soul. Help us to put our faith and trust in You. Lord Jesus, if I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart that You died for my sins and God raised You from the dead to be Lord over my life, I will be saved, O God. I pray, O Lord, for many who are searching for You, O God. May they find You when they cry out, "Jesus, show me who You are." May You reveal Yourself to them through Your Holy Spirit, O God. I bring before You those who are facing difficult times, O God. You know it could be times of lack, O God. There may be no employment for people at home, O God. There may be very little food on the table, O God. You are Jehovah Jireh, our provider. You provided for the 5,000 people, O God, with 5 loaves and 2 fish, O God. And You are able to provide for us, O God. If You were able to heal the woman with the issue of blood, You are able to heal each and every sickness, O God. If we trust You, if we put our faith in You, by Your stripes we are healed, O God. Whatever trouble Your people may be facing, just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego stood steadfast putting their faith in you and their trust in you, O Lord. You did not put them to shame. You will not be putting your people to shame who put their faith and trust in you. You will be with them during these hard times, O God, and you will bring them out victoriously, O God. I want to bring marriages before you, O God. I pray, O Lord, for a supernatural intervention in the lives of couples, O God. Lord, that they will give their marriages to you, O Lord. They will put you at the center of their marriages, O God. They will bring what troubles them to you, O Lord, the sustainer, the one who is able to answer, the one who is able to change lives, O God. I bring addictions before you, O God. And I say, Father, those who are struggling with addictions right now, as your word says, Lord, no temptation has overcome you except what is common to men. And God provides a way of escape so you can stand up under it. He won't give you more than you can bear. Lord, help us to stand on your word and through faith believe that we can overcome every temptation that comes our way through the power of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for coming to this earth to save us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your blood. We bless you and we worship you. Amen.
Good morning, our beloved CIC family. We greet you in the loving name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We miss you so much and we really long to see you. We pray that Jesus will continue to watch over your precious life. He would guide you in everything that you do. Please gather your family together on our Good Friday morning service. We will serve communion together. Pastor Bradley and his lovely wife Sheena will lead in the service. So we look forward to seeing you and God bless you and love you all.
Well, we've come to the end of a wonderful, wonderful service. And all that's left for me to do is to pronounce the benediction. And I do so in the context of everybody being at home. This is the blessing. We go out into the grace of this day's light, in the power of our great God, with the blessing of Jesus and the radiance of the Holy Spirit. May the joy and peace and the strength of God our Creator be with us always. Have a wonderful, wonderful day and a great week ahead.
Come on everybody, put your hands together. It's got to get better. All over the world, listen to these words. People come.
People come.
People go.
People go.
Your life has been.
Your life has been.
Out of control.
Out of control.
You're confused.
You're confused.
But don't worry.
Don't worry your soul. It will get better.
It's gotta get
better. It will get better.
It's gonna be
better. It will get better.
Cause
God is in control,
y'all.
Don't ever
depart. better.